So welcome back, aliens. I'm Navin Reddy from Telescope Learnings. On Facebook, on YouTube, I was getting lots of questions. What is testing? How to achieve testing? And why, as a developer, you should know testing? So I'm not that good in testing, and that's why. So I've asked one of my friends, she's in corporate training from a long time. It's been 6 years, and she has taken training in all different companies. You can name it, you can name the company, and she has done her training there. So for testing, for development, she has done the training for all this domain. And so let me introduce Shalini Mittal, and she'll be talking about what is unit testing and what is software testing in this video.
Hello friends, and this is Shalini Mittal, and I welcome you all on this small demo on unit testing. Now, the topic for today will be unit testing, which comes under a part of software testing. Now, software, we all know, that's a system that we create for make our jobs easier. Software creation, or when I say software, when we get the requirements. So basically, software in a whole starts from the moment you get the requirements from the client. You assess the requirements, you analyze them, and then you create the designs for them. We have the design structure. Then you go ahead for the implementations of the same. Of course, then there are life cycles, like you go for testings, and then the quality assurance, the user acceptance testing. You go and deploy on the client side, and then later on, when everything gets approved, is when you actually deploy the software or the application created by you on the client side. Software testing starts from the moment you start with getting the business requirements. So it's suggested that the earlier you do the testing, better it is for you to get less bugs, less errors, and create a more error-free applications. Now, what is testing and why it is needed? I guess in day-to-day life, suppose when I'm going for any shopping, right? If I'm just buying apples, every time I do test each and every apple, and I do touch it, maybe smell it, or maybe I ask lots of questions even before buying anything. Why? Because I'm paying money for that, right? We do testing at each and every phase of our life. You get up in the morning, you switch on the light, if it's working or not, right? I go in the kitchen. In the kitchen when I'm working, I do testing at every part of my life, at every part of the stage. It's so natural to us that we don't realize it's a part of our life that we're doing testing at all the times, right? We go and inquire for any classes. Now, for example, you want to come for this class as well. It's not that you inquire at one class and that's it. You join them, right? You inquire at many places. Now, what's the reason behind that? Of course, it's you want to get better quality for the money that you are paying. So testing at every phase in our real life, we have it in and around of us. So then why not include that testing in our software development lifecycle? Of course, when I talk about the software development lifecycle or the phases of software development, it starts with the requirements gathering, to the design, to the implementations, to the testing part, to quality assurance, and go on and further. Today's topic, I won't be focusing on the whole life cycle, but I will be focusing on one part of the software testing, that is unit testing. Now, why unit? That term comes along with testing. Now, as discussed, testing we know that we require so that we get better quality, right? We know in advance that whatever we are delivering, right, it is as far as with par to the client's requirements and less error prone. Unit implies that the smallest unit in your particular modules that you can test. For unit testing, if you compare in terms of Java, the smallest unit in a Java program is nothing but a class. And classes has method. So you basically try to test the functionality of how the classes or the methods that you have designed, they are going to work independently, irrespective of in and around situations. So that is what it means by unit testing. That is, we are going to test each and every small module of our application, and smallest module in Java application is nothing but a class. Class comprises of methods, and methods has what? Behavior. Or I can say it consists of functionality. Each individual piece of our classes, we would want to go for testing, setting the expectations, what exactly we expect, and then running it and testing it and seeing it whether whatever expectations we had from our modules, is it actually performing the way that we expected to, right? So we are going to test the functionalities. Now, before I dwell into the J unit testing or the unit testing, we'll just have a quick overlook as to all the available lifecycle phases in software testing. We have unit testing, we have integration testing, we have system testing, we have user acceptance testing, and then at the last, we have the release. Unit testing is the part which is done by the developer. So developers are responsible for providing the unit testing within their applications. Integration testing, system testing, then you have the various testers available who are responsible then to integrate all the modules first one by one, test them, and then the whole system integrated as a whole. Now when I talk about system, system may imply you have servers, you have databases, you have the browsers, you have the machines, you have the operating systems, you have the software itself. So system implies testing each and everything that's included into your applications. We go about, once the testing is done from our side, then we go with the user acceptance testing. It is nothing but the user, that is the client, he basically then tests it. Now this testing can be done at the client side or it can be done at the service provider side. Once the user acceptance testing is done and the application is with the power of the requirements of the client, then it goes for the release testing. Again, release, you have two versions, you have the alpha and you have the beta version. So alpha versions is still again in the testing phase, and then you have the beta versions. Again, there are few testing strategies available. Like, we have testing strategies, they are white box and black box testing. Then next we have functional and non-functional testing. We have static and dynamic testing. Okay, so we have all these kinds of testing strategies available, out of which the unit testing is a kind of white box testing, wherein we are going to test for the functionalities in our applications, and this testing can be static or can be dynamic. Now when I talk about white box testing, it implies that I, as a developer, knows in and out of the code. I can actually view, I know every line written because it's all white, it's open to me. When I talk about black box testing, that's done by the testers, wherein they don't know about the coding that's been done behind the scenes. They just check for the functionality. For example, a login application, so they might be testing whether the login application, when I log in, does it redirects to a login page or to an error page? Does the second page comes up or not? Or when I click on a button and login credentials are wrong, in that case, does it display the error messages properly or not? Right? This is all done by the testers, which comes under the black box testing. We have functional and non-functional requirements in our applications. We also have static and dynamic testing, wherein static testing is, I'm writing my code and I want it to be get reviewed by my peers or my managers or anyone. So they are not actually executing the code. The only thing is they are basically reviewing it. So it can be documents reviews, walkthrough reviews. It can be done without executing the code. So if you're not executing the code, getting it reviewed by your peers, it is called as static testing. Dynamic testing is when you actually start the execution of your programs and you are actually testing it, what's the output of your applications. So we have few testing strategies, and of course nothing goes if you don't have some principles, rules to follow. Should we check for all the possibilities, even for the negative values? Yes, why not, right? When you buy a car, the car, before being on roads, it's being tested and driven through all kinds of conditions. It's not tested only for the ideal conditions. Especially when I go to buy a car, I will not test a car on the smooth road. I'll definitely take the car onto the road where there will be bumpers or there will be potholes or their roads should be curvy, and test it so that while I'm buying a car, I know that it will run on Indian roads, specifically on the Indian roads, right? So when in real life we go on about all these testing principles, why not apply all these rules into our software applications as well? So always remember, you need to test for all kinds of scenarios. Do not work for only ideal conditions. Whatever possible values you think are impossible, you should test for all the impossible values as well. So this is all about a small overview onto what is software testing. Now the main topic for today is unit testing. Now unit testing with respect to Java is done by using a library called as JUnit. Now the version that you will be learning today, that is JUnit 4. So it's JUnit 4.x. So we had JUnit 3, which had few drawbacks. So we have JUnit 4, which comes in with rich features of Core Java, wherein it supports annotations, wherein it gives you the flexibilities of adding the libraries and getting your work done in a faster way. So the topic, the library that we are going to use for unit testing is nothing but JUnit 4. Is installation tough with JUnit 4? Not at all. You have Eclipse. I guess everyone is aware of Eclipse IDE. If not, we have another video on Eclipse tutorials. You can please watch that. JUnit 4 library installations, it's very easy. You just have the Eclipse IDE, wherein you just have to add the dependency for JUnit 4 library and you're good to go with it. Now, JUnit 4 library, it has some features available in it, right? So the features are, it basically tests for all the assertions. Now, what do you mean by assertions? Whenever we go and buy something, we assert ourselves that whether whatever we are buying, is it fulfilling our requirements or not, right? So J unit again talks about assertions. It has test fixtures. Do not worry about all these terms. If you don't know, we will be covering each and everything in details later. You have assertions, you have test fixtures, you have parameterized testing, you have mock frameworks available, which you can use for J unit